What about the next gen forehand? Yes, it is slightly different from the modern forehand. When we look at young players such as Carlos Alcaraz, Yannick Sinner, Lorenzo Musetti, or even some of the players that have been around a little bit longer, such as Thiem, Kyrgios, Zverev, or Shapovalov, they do hit the forehand a little bit different. So the difference is in the starting position of the racket. So the tip of the racket will point forward as they go into their looping action. So all the components of the modern forehand are still there, but one thing that all these players have in common is that the racket is slightly pointed forward. And now what will happen as a result of that, and you can try this out at home, if you take your racket in the starting position in a more forward way, now as you take your racket back, the racket will be more towards the outside. So take a look from this angle. If I have my tip of the racket forward, naturally as I take my racket back, the racket will be more towards the side. Now naturally, as the racket drops, the racket will start turning towards this side and eventually go into a lag position. When we compare the next gen forehand to more of a modern forehand, the difference is that the classic modern forehand, such as Federer or Nadal at certain portions of his career, or Kenta Shikori, have a vertical position of the racket as the racket is going back. So they don't put the racket forward, they have the racket going straight up. And naturally, as the racket drops, it is less likely to go this way. This will require a turn of the wrist and is less likely to happen. Take a look from this angle. As my racket is more vertical, when I take it back, it is going to drop in this way. And compare this to a next gen forehand. If I have the tip of the racket going forward, as I take my racket back, naturally the racket will be more pointing straight towards the side fence. Now, interestingly, Nadal has experimented with this type of backswing at certain portions of his career, but then reverted back to his regular way of taking the racket back. But the interesting thing about the next gen forehand is that players in the past have used this style as well. Andy Murray, for example, has also a position of the racket head that's more forward, and then naturally, as Murray takes his racket back, the racket is more pointing towards the side. Also, Andy Roddick had a slight forward position of the racket on his take back, and as he dropped the racket was also going more towards the side. And now if we go way back, we had a player called Jim Courier. Not sure if you remember him, but he was number one in the world. He also had a next-gen type forehand way back in the day. Jim used to have this racket completely pointing forward, and as he took it back, he achieved the same position as the next-gen players do.